All right. LDMMAC. This is your boy, Coach Shelton Harrison. You're live with the Coach Shelton Harrison Combat Sports Show Live. Okay, folks. So, you know, listen. I made a video. Okay? I made a video. And here's the thing, okay? You know, if listening was an Olympic event, there'd be no bronze medals, there'd be no silver medals, and there damn sure be no gold medals. That, please. You know, I got to start questioning some of the validity of people online. Like, I really got to start questioning some of the listening capabilities online. Like, I got to, because I'm sitting here and I'm thinking to myself, okay, what did these people miss? So let me break it down. On my last video, okay, we talked about the, Cyborg, her fan channel. They dropped some information. And, you know, for some reason, people just think that, coach believes that. Ha, ha, ha. Coach, you got to know, man, you're better than that. Okay. I never said that I believed anything. What I said was, let me tell you what I think. Nowhere did you come out and hear me say anything. I said, let me tell you what I think. And what I said was, I said, okay, Coach Shelton Harrison, me, okay, I said, listen, okay, listen, here's what it is, okay, this is what I believe. I believe that this really pretty much proves that Chris Cyborg isn't afraid of Amanda Nunes. I said it. Chris Cyborg is ready to go. Now, you look at the time frame, and I keep telling y'all timing, okay? Timing. Look at the time frame, okay? This is what I said. I said, now, it's possible, though, that the UFC, they could replace Spencer, but, you know, more than likely, maybe not. They could. The UFC, they've done stuff like this before. They've taken a fighter off of a card, and I mean, it's possible. But I didn't say that I believed the art. What I said was, I think that this definitely proves that Chris Cyborg isn't afraid of Amanda Nunes. She's not afraid. And what I then said is, why doesn't people ever question why Dana White doesn't talk about the tweet that Amanda Nunes sent? That's what I said. Why doesn't he ever question that tweet? And y'all know the tweet that I'm talking about. You know the one that I'm referring to. The tweet to where he's saying, or Amanda is saying, that listen, I don't want to fight Chris. Chris, I have no intention of fighting Chris anymore at 245. I mean at 145. But here, we got Kayla Judo Harrison. We got her. Okay, get ready for her. She legit. That'll be a good fight. Nobody talking about that. No. But you guys don't listen. You guys need to understand that the magnitude of this Cyborg Nunes 2. This is a huge fight. This fight is humongous. And I think a lot of y'all don't understand the magnitude of how much money. We're talking about probably, roughly. And I'm gonna give you a low, modest ballpark figure. We're talking about maybe $500 million that this fight is worth. Okay, and probably more than that. This fight is going to generate lots of pay-per-view. It's going to generate lots of revenue. You're talking about the people who got businesses all around the area. You're talking about, like, you know, airports, hotels, car rental places, food. Okay, you name it. This fight is going to positively affect those things. This is a big fight. And Dana White don't want to let these fights go. He don't want these fights to slip through his fingers. He wants this fight. And he's doing what he thinks he needs to do as a businessman to get these fights done. Trust me. See, he's saying that Chris turned the fight down. But see, Dana, he's trying to do as much as he can to try to, you know, give Chris as little as possible while taking in the rest for himself. That's what promoters do. And a guy asked me, he said, Coach, why would Dana hurt his own product? Why would he, you know, want UFC 240 to do bad? Let me ask you this, okay? Why would a man, and I want y'all to get this straight. Chris Cyborg is part of his brand. Chris Cyborg is part of his business. Why would he go and just really say things to make her look bad? Why would he do that? Why would he try to hurt his own brand? Because Chris Cyborg is a part of his company, part of his organization. Why would he say stuff to hurt his own brand? Isn't that negatively affecting his pockets when he do it? So you don't think this guy would actually do something to actually not promote this fight the way you're supposed to promote it? Okay, I'm talking about UFC 240. Okay, you don't think that this guy would even legitimately do something like that to affect the pay-per-view sales? See, look, the UFC, they do lots and lots and lots of pay-per-views every year. They do a lot of them. But see, here's the thing about that, okay? They're going to make some money, and sometimes they even lose money. Sometimes they break even, okay? But see, with this Nunes Cyborg 2, oh, they're going to do more than break even. They're going to make money hand over fist. Dana probably don't care too much about UFC 240 if they take a hit on it. He don't care. The man understands the bottom line. And the bottom line to him is he got to get that Cyborg Nunes fight at the end of the year. Remember that I told y'all this. Okay? He's got to get that fight. That's the bottom line. That's going to be the huge payday. It's at the end of the year. It's around the holiday season. Okay? And you know what? The fight probably going to be in Vegas, or he might put it in Brazil. But either way, he put it in those two places, anywhere else is crazy. He need to put it in Vegas or Brazil. And if he do either one, okay, the fights are going to do big numbers. They're going to do huge numbers. It's a money thing. I keep telling y'all, this man don't want to promote 240. Why is he not doing that? Think about it. Have you seen a lot of promotion for UFC 240? Have you? That was the context of what I was saying. And the fights on UFC 240, they suck. They suck. That was designed. Chris, they're not going to get a whole lot of press on that fight. They don't have a lot of interesting matchups on that fight. They help the support and they help the people. They don't have a good supporting cast at UFC 240. And then when the pay-per-view numbers don't do so hot, or if they don't do so hot, guess what Dana gonna say? He gonna sit Chris down and say, hey, Chris. He's gonna say, hey, Chris, listen, the numbers ain't do so well. Listen, you gotta be able to put asses in the seat, and you know, you weren't able to put the asses in the seat like you're supposed to. You weren't able to do it. So listen, this is what we offer you, this is what you get, and that's it. That's what's going to happen. Guys, that's what it is. I'm telling y'all, this is going to happen. They're going to try to work out a deal, and it's going to be like a shady deal. And it's going to be based off the Spencer fight. If Cyborg goes in and she clocks Spencer, oh, and by the way, how Cyborg beats Spencer, okay, that's going to depend upon, you know, what she get and how this fight's going to be done. Okay, how she beats Spencer. If she go in there and go a decision against Spencer, okay, he going to try to lowball it. See, he's going to have Chris in a position where Chris got to take the fight anyway. No matter what he offer, he'll throw anything out. Now, if Chris go in here and she clocks Spencer, I'm telling you, get her out of there in round one. Well, I mean, guess what? Guess what, okay? If Chris get her out of there in round one, then, you know, Chris, they're going to be able to negotiate. They're going to be able to play low ball. And if Chris lose the fight, then it is what it is. Okay, the Nunes 2 is probably dead. So Chris actually got to win this fight. And not only does she got to win it, she got to do it convincingly. The thing is stacked up against Chris Cyborg. Okay, it's stacked up. And because of Amanda's performance against Holly, see, now it's the deck of cards are stacked against Chris. So Chris got to go in here and show up and show out. Chris legitimately got to go in here and make this girl, I'm talking about take the soul out of Spencer's body. She got to do it. And Dana White and Amanda, they got the upper hand. Chris losing to Amanda, it just turned a lot of things, it turned a lot of things out. And so now that Chris has to do that much more, and the cards are stacked that much more against her. So yeah, Dana's gonna try to use this as a springboard, okay, to say, first he's gonna use the pay-per-view numbers, okay? He gonna do that first, and he gonna say the numbers ain't good enough. No matter what Chris do, he's gonna say the pay-per-view numbers ain't good enough to warrant you that kind of pay, okay? If the pay-per-view numbers are good and Chris, you know, go a decision with Spencer, he going to say, well, you know, the fight wasn't impressive and blah, blah, blah. That's what he going to say. And guess what? He going to try to find that excuse to lowball it. Okay? And then if Chris lose altogether, well, the fight's done. So there you have it. That's what we're looking at here. You guys, y'all start listening, man. This generation, for some reason, y'all just feel like y'all don't listen. Y'all ain't got to listen. You don't try to listen. You don't try to do anything. Like, y'all just take what, I mean, y'all listen to every word. This is what I always tell y'all. Listen to every word. Every word. Not some of the words, not part of the word. Listen to every single word. Because if you listen to every single word and read every single word, you start to understand what the context of what's being said. Jeez, man. Unbelievable. And I know people like Dennis Espinosa, TJ, they're shaking their head and hitting the wall with some of you young people, like with some of you 20-something. And I'm not picking on all of y'all, but a lot of y'all, man, y'all don't listen and you don't read. Go back and listen to the video. Get back to me.